Logging in as another user is a useful feature for developers, account administrators, or support personnel to assist customers experiencing issues. Today we'll look how we can build such functionality from scratch. Now this example is using the device gem for authentication, but it doesn't really matter what you're using yourself. It can be any other gem or authentication from scratch. It does not matter, it will still work, the code we'll be building is going to be agnostic. So in this application, users can add books to their cart and then make an order. So what I'd like to do is to allow admins to log in as these users and make orders on their behalf. So let me show you exactly what I mean. So I'm going to go to the admin panel, and here we can see all the users we have inside the database. So in addition to this remove button, I want to have another button here where you'd click on it and then you'd log in as this particular user. And then you'll be able to add books to the cart and maybe even make an order. So how can we do that? So if I want to log in as this account, we can see their ID is number 3. So the idea is that inside this path we'll also add another resource, and let's call this representation. And when the admins will hit this endpoint, they will log in as this particular user. And we'll probably use this endpoint for logout as well. In any case, I like the name representation because it doesn't involve any potential malice like impersonation or takeover. Anyway, so let's build this functionality. And to do so, I'm going to jump to the routes file. And within the users resource, I'm going to create another resource. And this should be representation. And do notice, this is singular. However, when naming the controller, it should actually be plural. So this should be representations controller.rb. And I'm actually going to copy some code from the users. So we'll have the admin authentication here as well. And then replace users with representations. Inside here, we should have two actions, one for logging in. So let's call this create because it's a RESTful resource, and another one, destroy. However, I'm going to leave this blank for now so we can do things by the book and write the test first. So I'm going to go to the spec folder, and I'm going to create a file called representation controller spec.rb. Alright, so first of all, you need to test the logging action. So I'm going to do it inside the describe block, and the description will be the verb, which is a post, and the action, which is create. Now, before actually writing the expectation, we do need some sample data. So first of all, that's the user we're currently logged in as, which I'll name current user. And I'm going to use FactoryBot to create it. And another user, and this is the user we want to log in as. Still said, I don't like this name, but I'll call this impersonated user. And then I'm going to make a subject with what this method will basically do. So this should be a post to the create action, and we'll pass it in the user we want to log in as a parameter. So this should be user ID. Impersonated user. You don't need to put here ID, it will know how to read it from the resource itself. And then we need to write an expectation. Usually I test the happy path first, that is when everything goes according to plan, and then the edge cases. But things related to authentication such as this, it's actually better to do it the other way around. So basically, rather than testing that we can log in as this user, first of all, we're going to test that we can't log in because we're not really an admin. So for example, this account is just a regular account. It's not an admin. Therefore, you can't really log in with this user. So let's write that expectation. So let's just call it, it does not change the current user. The expectation should be expect subject to not change controller current user from current user. So basically nothing happens when we do this. Now I don't like subject here. The name itself doesn't provide any meaning. So I'm going to rename this and call it perform request. And now this reads a bit better. Expect perform request to not change the current user from current user. So let's do try it out. So this fails because we're actually not logged in. Now we're not really going to log in, we're just going to pretend that we are. So to do that, we need to mock the controller current user to return our current user instance. So I'll just say allow controller to receive current user and return our user instance. And now if we run the specs again, they pass. Cool, so now we need to write a spec when we can actually log in. So I'm going to write a context here, and this should be as an admin. And here we should be able to log in. And in order to do that, we need to overwrite the current user. And I'll just do that. So this should be admin true now. So the expectation should be it changes the current user. Pretty much the opposite of the other one. So actually I'll just copy this line. So expect perform request to change current user from current user to impersonated user. Now let's do break these to multiple lines. So let's run the spec. Okay, so it has not changed. So let's fix this. So I'm going to jump to the presentations controller. And here, first of all, we'll search for the user we want to log in as. And then this should be user ID. And then we want to store this user ID inside the session. I'm going to name this delegated user ID equals user.id. Now granted, we could have set here params user ID directly, but I don't like to just blindly read params this way. And who knows, maybe in the future we can extend this to say, hey, without admins, so admins can't log in as another admin, for example. In any case, then we need to make some other changes inside the application controller. So let's do that. Application controller. The way things work in Ruby is that, say we have a method called foo, and this returns some string. If we redefine this method, the thing is that in this case application controller is going to use this definition of foo, and this logic is actually quite important for what we need to do. Right now we have a method called current user. We can't really see it, but basically device provides it for us. So this basically already exists. If you're using something else, maybe current attributes, you might need to make these changes in a separate file. But for us, current user is actually defined inside this file, even though we can't really see it. So what we're going to do, we're going to make a copy of this current user method, which as I said is here, but we can't see it. So I'm going to use alias method to do this. So this should be alias method. And this is the new name, original current user. And this, and the second argument is the existing name, current user. So right now we have two methods which do the same thing, but despite the name alias, this is actually a copy. So for example, if I override current user to do something else here, original current user will still be the same, well, as the original current user, as the name implies. Anyway, so what this means is that here we can make a check, for example, if session delegated user ID, then it should return, well, let's just do user find our delegated user ID. And if not, we'll just do things as we previously did. So nothing has really changed here. Cool. So now let's try the specs again and see if this actually fixed the issues we have. Okay, so you see nothing has really changed despite what we've just did. So let's have another quick peek at the specs. And the issue is that we stop the controller. So in a way, we don't really do anything because obviously controller will always return our stubbed current user. So rather than stubbing current user, we should rather stub the original current user. And now if we run the specs again, they will indeed pass. So let's make a link and see that this functionality is indeed working. So right now we have this removed, so we're going to add another link that when you click on it, you will log in as that user. So I'm going to jump to the user index template, the page we've just seen, and I'll copy the remove link and rename it to login on user's behalf. And the path should be admin user representation. And because this is the create action, the action should be a post. I did forget something though. Inside the representation controller, we do need to redirect, especially because we're no longer an admin, at least not technically. So this should be redirect to root. Cool. So now if we click on a user, we can see we're logged in as that particular user. And now it's time to actually build the logout functionality, because right now if you log out, you basically are logged out for good. You don't return to your admin account. A good authentication system should reset the session on logout, which is something that device did just now. Nevertheless, some other systems might not do that. So inside the application controller, I'm going to check that in addition to the delegated user ID, the user is still logged in. And not just that, it's logged in as an administrator. So I'm just going to copy this line and use it here. But I can't do current user inside current user because it will be a recursive call. So I'm just going to check for the original current user. And now, in addition to that logout scenario, say this original current user has been demoted and is no longer an admin, they won't be able to be logged in as the delegated user ID. Anyway, back to the representations controller. The destroy action will be accessible by anyone because the users are no longer admins. And as such, I'm going to add here except destroy. Well, this should be a symbol. So now let's write some specs for this method. So I'm going to jump to the spec and I'm going to add a new describe block for our destroy method. The verb is delete and the action is destroy. I'm going to copy all the code from the create describe block, paste it in, and I'll just make a bunch of adjustments here. So first of all, these are actually the same as the other spec, So we're going to move them to the top. And as such, we'll be able to remove them from the create spec. And as for the destroy action, this should be delete, destroy. And yeah, we should probably just remove all these lines. And here, the expectation should pretty much be the opposite. So we expect impersonated user to become the current user. So we do need to stop the session, otherwise the current user is already, well, the current user rather than being the impersonated user. So I'm going to say session delegated user ID equals impersonated user.id. And now let's do run the spec again. And we can see that the user has not changed, so we should fix this. We're going to jump to the representations controller, and here we will delete the delegator user ID and then redirect to root. And if we run the specs again, we can see that they pass. In order to show a different logout link here, if you're an admin, we need some further information exposed to the view. So I'm going to jump to the application controller here, and I will create another method called delegated user question mark, and this returns true or false if this user is delegated or not. And I'll just copy these lines here. Anyway, we want to expose this method to the view now, so I'm going to use a helper method. So this should be helper method delegated user. And while we are at it, let's expose the original current user as well. So if your application has multiple admins, you can know who exactly you are logged in as. Cool. So now let's jump to the application HTML view. And here we can see the current logout link. So basically, if this user is a delegated user, we will show a different link. Else, we will show the current link. So let's copy this link. And here we'll say maybe leave client session. And this link should be, well, admin current user representation. It's a bit long. Anyway, if we try things again, we'll see that we have another link here and it says leave client session. And if we do, we're back to the admin account. Because we exposed the original user, we can do even more. So for example, here we could say if the user is a delegated user, we can say who exactly this user is. So let's say original current user.name. So maybe you really are this particular user. So now if we log in as someone, you can see you really are administrator because this is the user's name. And we can leave and go back in. The problem with logging in into someone's account is that you can do whatever you want there. And perhaps this is what you really want to, but say we want admins to be able to add things to someone's cart, but only the user should be able to actually place the order once that has been done. So how can we prevent administrators from doing this? Inside the application controller, I'm going to create another method called ensure not delegated. So here we'll check if the user is delegated or not, and if they are, we'll basically redirect to the home page and we'll provide it a message saying, sorry, you're not allowed to do that. And let's enforce that. Go to the orders controller, and here I'll also check that the user is not delegated. And if we try to place an order now, we can see a message saying, sorry, you're not allowed to do that. And the thing is, you can still place items and remove them, but this action is now restricted to admins. One other restriction we might enforce is preventing administrators from using someone else's account for longer than a specific period of time. So let's see how we can enforce this. So I'm going to do this really quick. First of all, we're going to store the timestamp when the session should expire. And I'll call this key delegated user expires at, and I'll provide it some future timestamp, could be 3 hours from now, for example. But do remember, you can only store things such as integers or strings inside the session, so I will typecast this to an integer. And because we have added a value, we also need to delete it. So this should be session delete delegated user expires at. I said expires at. Anyway, you might be wondering, why store things inside the session? Why not use a cookie? And the reason is that users can change the expiration date of that cookie. So I'd rather not do that. So in order to enforce this rule, I need to add an extra condition inside the application controller. So here we'll also check that the current timestamp is greater than the current time. So the current timestamp is delegated user expires at. Now this is an integer, so I want to convert it to a time, and I'm going to use time.at. So this should be greater than time.now. So basically by now, if we log in as someone, we'll be logged in as them only for a specific time. I'll just change this value really quick. Let's just say 3 seconds from now. So the session will be just 3 seconds to see that this truly is working. So I'll just log in as this user. And now if I refresh the page, you can see that it has changed. So this is basically logging in as another user in a nutshell. You might want to memoize this value, because right now we're making a query here every single time. But this does make testing a bit harder, that's why I didn't do it. But if you have many admins, you definitely should do it. Anyway, this is about it. I will catch you in the next video.